One interesting phenomenon where you hear the greatest cardiovascular surgeons apologize to the world at large, from the Cleveland Clinic, from the Mayo Clinic, from Stanford, from Harvard, saying we were wrong for 40 years. We were telling people that when you eat foods high in cholesterol and high in saturated fats, that that level in your body then moves into your arteries, it lines the arteries with plaques, and before you know it, that coronary artery that's feeding your blood, its oxygen, is closing off, and then all of a sudden you get a heart attack. It's those doggone fats that people eat. Well, we know that the fats are anti-inflammatory. It's the carbohydrates that we consume that cause inflammation of those vascular linings. That inflammation causes those linings to scar, and it's that inflamed scar that then attracts the cholesterol and saturated fats that causes claudication, the difficult peripheral vascular disease that makes it difficult to walk, the poor carotid circulation that gives your brain its oxygen. That's the reality we're faced with now. That's not fad. That's not just a passing interest. That's reality. And until Americans and the world at large figure out that the solution to the ever-burgeoning coronary artery disease and peripheral vascular disease is due to carbohydrates, they can continue to convince themselves that that fat-free food that they see labeled on their licorice and their candies are going to keep them from getting heart disease. No, it's that very type of food that's going to lead towards those types of pathologic entities. That's the reality America is finding. That's the acute life-saving aspect of keto adaptation.